6月14号中午晚间十点，宫市主题之夜，日本海上长城。
Watching PBS English News, I'm Mariam Xie. Protests over Hong Kong's extradition law have turned violent in the special administrative region over the past few days. On June 13th, a large group of Hong Kong students studying in Taiwan held a press conference to call on President Tsai Ing-wen to add human rights review mechanisms into the laws and regulations regarding Hong Kong and Macau affairs. By doing so, they hope that Hong Kong government officials and police who oppress and send dissidents to China will be prohibited to come to Taiwan.
反送中! A group of Hong Kong students currently studying in Taiwan held a press conference in front of the presidential office on the 13th and called on Taiwan's government to add human rights review mechanisms to the laws and regulations regarding Hong Kong and Macau affairs to prevent Hong Kong government officials and police who oppress dissidents from entering Taiwan.
台湾作为移民的一个审办方、审查方，可以让那个人权的条件可以作为一个很主要的考虑条件。
台湾可以作为一个先例，让其他全世界可能欧美国家或是其他有民主自由的国家，让他们知道，我们一起这样做的时候，香港政府会怕。
A domestic civic group voiced its support and called on the Tsai administration to condemn the Hong Kong government's extradition law.
台湾一直以来就是我们已经是一个这么亚洲地区比较民主人权的国家，那一直没有一个相关的对于寻求庇护者的保护机制跟审查机制，我觉得这个其实是很有问题的。
National Cheng Kung University students also voiced their support.
在台湾未来有可能碰到一样的情况，那如果碰到这样的情况，我们是不是应该站出来，或是我们应该用什么样的心态去面对这样的议题？
The Hong Kong students submitted a petition to the presidential office and said they hope to get a positive response from President Tsai Ing-wen. In response, the presidential office said Tsai is closely monitoring the developments in Hong Kong, and Taiwan will never accept any actions aimed at eradicating national sovereignty. It also said Taiwan rejects any proposals that require legal revisions as a precondition and will never be party to malevolent laws.
Nantou County's mountainous areas are suffering from disasters triggered by recent heavy rains. Guoxing Township's Dati Village suffered mudslides and road beds collapsed in Changfeng Village. Meanwhile, a bridge at Provincial Highway No. 14 also collapsed, resulting in a deep hole 25 meters wide.
Mud and rocks flow down the mountainside. Their residence is located just several meters away, and the homeowners say they have been living in constant fear of their homes collapsing due to the heavy rain that has continuously fallen during the past several days. This is the current situation in the village of Dachi in Nantou County's Guoxing Township. Residents say large sections of the mountainside collapsed. They fear their homes will be affected soon and have made preparations to evacuate should the need arise. The village is located in a mountainous area, and the heavy rain during the past several days has saturated the soil, resulting in mudslides. Meanwhile, the impact of an overflowing river washed away a roadbed in Changfeng Village.
然后水管都被用断了。
啊，会不会担心大雨来再继续冲下来？
当然会啊。
Over in Anai Township, people experienced a landslide along Pulu Highway on June 12th. On the same day, local authorities received reports that the roadbed had collapsed on the 75.8-kilometer mark of Provincial Highway No. 14, resulting in a 25-meter long and 18-meter deep hole.
把我们下方原本有的一个拦沙坝冲毁掉，那导致整个溪床整个下刷，然后连带我们引道的一个溢墙整个被流失。
As this road is the principal thoroughfare to Qingjing Farm in Hehuan Mountain, the Director General of Highways immediately closed off one side of the highway and dispatched equipment to fill and repair the roadbed. The public is advised to avoid traveling to mountainous areas during times of heavy rain.
On June 6th, a criminal arrested for theft took a chance to escape while making an appearance at the Yunlin District Court. He nearly succeeded by claiming that he felt sick, and the marshal didn't put his leg cuffs back on when sending him back to the custody room. To prevent similar incidents in the future, the Yunlin District Court said it will review what happened and strengthen the educational training of marshals.
After appearing in court, a 41-year-old felon surnamed Liao claimed to be feeling unwell as he was being taken back into custody. The marshal therefore didn't put his leg cuffs back on and even went to fetch a swivel chair for him. Liao took advantage of the opportunity to make a break for it, but was captured almost immediately. Liao is serving time until 2023 for drugs and theft. On the 6th, he was sent to court without leg cuffs but with a heavier marshal escort than usual after claiming to be suffering from gout pain. The court says it is reviewing whether additional marshal training is needed. A court official says the video was leaked after being sent out internally as a friendly reminder to marshals, and the performance appraisal committee will punish the person or persons responsible. The official also said the absence of exclusive routes for criminals within the 55-year-old court complex makes marshals' jobs harder and puts them at risk, and this can hopefully be remedied in the future.
Can schools issue on-campus traffic fines? In National Pingtung University of Science and Technology, there's a rule that students who run red lights will receive a fine of $200. However, one student's now saying that schools doesn't have the right to fine students' money. In response, the school said the regulation is legal under college autonomous laws.
National Pingtung University of Science and Technology has Taiwan's largest campus. Students often ride scooters to get across campus, and traffic lights can be found at intersections. Students caught running red lights are fined $200. Like real-world traffic fines, fine slips are stamped by campus military instructors and include details like violation and location. Some students say the system deters violations, while others say it is illegal. The university says the fine system is legal in accordance with college autonomous laws, and fine revenues are used to promote traffic safety awareness. Under relevant Ministry of Education regulations, however, schools are not permitted to fine or infringe on the property of students. The university says it will review the system for potential conflicts.
3 days ago, the Ocean Conservation Administration and the Kuroshio Ocean Education Foundation surveyed Taiwan's Southwest Sea area to learn more about the distribution of microplastics in floating marine debris. Their observation showed that the marine debris was primarily composed of styrofoam, plastics, and plastic bottles.
Researchers have taken ships out to sea and are using nets to collect microplastics on the sea surface. On June 10th and 11th, the Ocean Conservation Administration and the Kuroshio Ocean Education Foundation conducted a survey of Taiwan's Southwest Sea area to learn more about the distribution of microplastics and floating marine debris. The area they surveyed had Locho Island as a southern boundary and the Bajang River estuary as a northern boundary.
海漂垃圾很多都是从陆源过来的，因此呢，就是我们民众的这个生活习惯呢，其实就会影响到就是我们的海洋的一个环境。This
was the first time that a government agency had taken part in a survey of microplastic pollution in the ocean. During the 2 days, researchers took samples from 12 locations. They traveled 160 nautical miles and observed that styrofoam made up a large portion of the floating marine debris.
观测的点呢，两天总共有66件。那以这个它的种类来讲呢，其实就是宝丽龙、其他的塑胶还有宝特瓶。
The Ocean Conservation Administration intends to continue working with the Kuroshio Ocean Education Foundation to get a better understanding of the trash situation in the waters surrounding Taiwan. It has also commissioned the National Museum of Marine Biology and Aquarium to conduct an investigation on microplastics in marine animals in order to progressively compile information on and establish a system to investigate marine debris.
Following the appearance of fall armyworms in Miaoli, the Council of Agriculture confirmed the second and third case in fields of Yilan and Jiayi. To encourage people and farmers to report sightings, the council is offering cash reward of $10,000. Farmers, meanwhile, will receive compensation for destroying damaged crops and another $45,000 per month per hectare payment for the three-month period they cannot grow crops.
This sweet corn field in Yilan's Tochen has been sealed off. The leaves on the plants show insect damage. The farmer says he usually uses biological pesticides to get rid of pests, but decided to report the damage this time in case he was dealing with fall armyworms. This turned out to be the case. The farmer cleared the field, which cost him $30,000 in losses. However, he says infestation prevention is more important than financial losses. The farmer also says the $3,000 per fin compensation the government is offering is not enough of an incentive to convince farmers to destroy infested crops. To get rid of the corn plants, the farmer had to dig a 3-meter deep hole, place the corn plants in the hole, and spray them with calcium cyanamide to ensure no larvae survive. Fall armyworms were recently reported in a cornfield in Jiayi's Lucao as well. There have been 3 confirmed cases in Taiwan so far. The Bureau of Animal and Plant Health Inspection and Quarantine says only larvae have been found at present time, and it hopes the larvae are first generation and can be completely eradicated by burying or burning. The Bureau is also offering cash rewards for reporting armyworm sightings. Unlike the ones found in Miaoli, the armyworms found in Yilan and Jiayi are a rice paddy variety. The Bureau says it can't forecast damage right now, but farmers that destroy infested crops will receive compensation of $45,000 per hectare during the 3 months they can't farm.
Thank you for watching PBS English News. I'm Mariel Xie. See you next time.
MRT2
啊，那也真少了。
白鹤眼，你看
这个很多较好的办法。
哇，外班机啊！
我是以前有实地以后，伊要会记住物件，所以高丽菜大理伊的办公店
啊，一定是有伊唔敢讲、歹势讲的状况。
照顾条件多，互咱做伙找出路，看见希望。台湾第一个提升照顾能力的节目，十年台湾。
做拖工艰苦，做拖工的某嘛艰苦。
是啊。
鼓励这出戏演的，就是你甲我的故事。内面有笑容，有目屎，嘛真有温度。七月时阵，邀请你做伙来收看，鼓励。
7月27号开始，每礼拜六暗时9点。